Welcome back to the Kotlin tutorial series, friends. This is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In this video, we will learn about a tool that we should never use in our Android projects, and that is called run blocking. As you can see, it is clear from the name that it is something that blocks our thread. So if you want to use run blocking, you can simply write run blocking like this, and it is another function from coroutines. And inside run blocking, you are also inside a coroutine scope. But the problem with run blocking is it blocks the current thread. For example, here we are inside the UI thread, or you can say main thread. So what this run blocking will do, run blocking will block the main thread, and as a result it will also block the onDraw function from updating our UI, and it will lead to an unresponsive application. For example, if you do some complex thing inside run blocking, but for now we don't have any complex computational thing to do, that will take some time. So what we will do here is we will use another function from the coroutines library that is called delay. Now what delay does is it simply delays the execution with the given milliseconds. So let's say I want to delay this thing, this block, for 5 seconds. So I will put 5000 here. 5000 means 5 seconds. Now this run blocking will block the main thread for 5 seconds. Let me show you by running the application. You can see our application is blocked, and after 5 seconds it shows up. So this run blocking blocked our UI thread for 5 seconds, and that we should not do in our application because it will lead to unresponsive application that we never want to make. So I hope you understood what a run blocking does. It again executes a code, but in a synchronous way or a blocking way. And to show you this thing, I can write a println statement here. Let's say println, and I will write here outside blocking scope. Then here I will print inside blocking scope, and after this I will write blocking scope finished. Let's see what happens this time. I have added a filter of system.out, and you can see we are outside blocking scope, then we are inside blocking scope, and it blocked our thread for 5 seconds, and then we see this blocking scope finished. So that means it blocked our main thread for 5 seconds, then it came outside. So that is why in Android you should never use this run blocking function. You can use it for testing purpose or debugging purpose, but you should never use it for your production application because it will block your UI thread. So far in this coroutine series, we learned about two things that we should never use. The first one was global scope.launch, and the next thing is run blocking. So I hope you understood that what is run blocking and why we should not use it, because it converts our asynchronous code to synchronous. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. In case you love my content, then please hit on that like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this video with your friends, and please help me reach my 100k subscriber quickly. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan, now signing off.